What is the same about every candle you see on the screen right now? I know what you're thinking. They're all green, right? And although that is true, that's not the similarity I'm talking about. The similarity I'm talking about makes them all good possible buying opportunity candles. And if you haven't spotted it yet, don't worry. This video is going to talk about candlestick chart secrets, one of them being this insanely accurate candlestick pattern that I'm going to show you in this video. So we're going to start the video in just a second with, I'm going to teach you what a candlestick is. For those of you who are brand new at trading, this will help, and I'm going to show you what each of them mean. After that, we're going to dive into this incredible candlestick pattern. I'm going to show you exactly how to spot it. Then I'm going to show you how to combine it with other things in order to trade it. We're going to take a look at some examples, and we'll take a look at some back-tested data of a strategy I've already tested in historical data. So we're going to get through all that in today's video. Go ahead and click that subscribe button down below the video to the right-hand side. Click that like button for me to help out with the YouTube algorithm. Follow us over on Instagram at the Trading Channel, and I'll see you after the intro and disclaimer. Welcome back, guys. Let's dive right into today's content. So for those of you who are brand new at trading, I'm going to go through quickly what a candlestick is and what they represent. And those of you who have already been trading for a while and you already understand these concepts, there'll be a timestamp in the description to take you straight to the candlestick pattern I'm going to be teaching you today. But for those of you who are new, let's go ahead and get started. Right here, we have daily chart candles. You've seen these before. They're normally green and red. But what do they actually mean? Well, these candlesticks are nothing more than a representation of price moving over a certain period of time. A daily chart would be a representation of a full day of price. If this was a 1 hour chart and not a daily chart, it would be a representation of 1 day of price. And what they need to be recognized as is with a green candle, the green candle normally represents an up day, meaning that this area here is the open. The bottom of the body is the open. This here is the low. It is the low point of the candle. The bottom of that wick is the low point of this 24-hour period represented by our green candle. This high point is the high of this 24-hour period, and this is the close of that candle. So if this candle would have started at 5 p.m. and then ended at 5 p.m. Eastern time, then this is exactly what it would look like if we had an open here, price moved down from our open to our low, price then moved back up to our high, and then price came back down and finally closed right here. That is exactly what these candlesticks mean. That's the representation of a green candlestick or a positive day in price if you're looking at a daily chart. A negative day is shown by this red candle here. So on this red candle, we have a very similar setup, except instead of the bottom of the body being the open, on a red candle, the top of the body is the open. The top of this wick is still the high of this candle. The bottom wick is still the low of this candle, and the bottom of the body is the close of this candle. So in the representation of this candle, what we would have seen if we were watching this on a daily chart is this candle would have opened here. It then would have pushed up to the high and then pushed all the way down to the low and then eventually pushed back up to close that 24-hour period right there at the bottom of this red candle. So that's how you see a candlestick, and that's how you break down the anatomy of each and every one of these candlesticks. It represents a certain amount of time depending on the time period you're on. Everything would be exactly the same if this was 1 hour instead of daily. If this was 1 hour, then that would still be the exact same anatomy of a candlestick. So now that we've broken that down a little bit, let's head down to a different white screen and take a look at the four green candles we were looking at right at the intro of the video. So now, can you spot the similarities of any of these? Right now, what I'm gonna do is go ahead and tell you the similarity and teach you the candlestick pattern that I never hear talked about here on YouTube, and that I think is one of the most accurate candlestick patterns you can use for a buying trade. And that is, each one of these candles closes in the top 95% of the candle. Each one of these candles has either a tiny wick on it or no wick on the top at all. And with these being green candles, what that means is at the end of whatever time period, let's just say we're still on the daily for simplicity, at the end of whatever time period we are looking at, this candle closed nearly at its high, at the highest point that the participants of the market pushed this candle, it dropped barely any, which means there was not many sellers at the end of this candle. At the end of this period, if we have little to no wicks on the top of these candles, that means there were no sellers at the end of this period. So that gives us a good representation that we could possibly see a market head higher from a candlestick like this. And the way I define this, whenever I'm trading on a 4-hour chart, I mostly trade on 4-hour, and you can set a Fibonacci retracement like this. Let me go ahead and show you how to identify the candle. So you can take a Fibonacci retracement. Let me put it on my candle. You can then adjust your Fibonacci retracement number, change it to 0.05%. And now all you have to ask yourself is, did this candle, you pull a retracement from the low of the candle to the high of the candle, did this candle land, the body of the candle, close above the top 5% of the candle? And if the answer is yes, then you have a correct candlestick formation. And as you can tell, each of these do that. So that's one way to spot this candlestick pattern. What I do is just look for the market to only have a 5 pip wick at the top of the candle or less. 5 to 6 pips is the max. So a max 5 to 6 pip wick on the top of the candle when I'm trading on a 4-hour chart. But you can also use the Fibonacci tool. That might make it a little bit easier for you. Like I said, grab your Fibonacci tool with the correct setting of a 5%, top 5% of the candle, and then boom, there we have it. Every time you want to see if you are trading the correct pattern, you can just use a Fibonacci tool and make sure that that candlestick closed in the top 5%. And again, if it did close in that top 5%, then chances are there was no selling pressure at the end of that time period. So chances are there's gonna be buying pressure in the next period. And that's what makes this candlestick pattern so powerful. Now let's move on to actually finding a few of these on chart data. And then I'll teach you a full strategy you can actually test and show you my backtesting data of that strategy right after we go over this candlestick pattern on actual charts. See you in just a second. All right, so what I want you to do right now is see if you can spot a few of these candlestick patterns. And by the way, they have to be green. It has to be a green candle that closes in the top 95%. See if you can spot any of them on the chart. All right, do you got it? Let's circle a few of them. Here, we have a candle that closes in the top 95%. The market pushes higher. And by the way, I'm going to teach you a bearish version of this as well. This is exactly what I'm talking about. We have a bearish candle now that closes in the bottom 5% of this candle. With that being the case, this would also be a trade. So I'm going to point it out, but I'm going to teach you the bearish version, which is exactly the same, but flipped, but I'll go over it anyway in just a second. We have the market pushing down. Then we have what? Another one of these candlesticks that I'm going to call the 5% candle because it closes in the top 5% of the candle itself. We have a green candle closing in the top 5%. Let's call it a 5% candle. And these are just three examples of them actually on the chart. So now let's take a look at the bearish version of this. All right, so now I want you to see if you can spot any of the bearish versions of this same exact 5% candlestick pattern. Did you spot this one? Here at the top, we have one here. Let's keep looking. I'll circle it. One there, market falls. We have another one here, market continues to fall. We have another one here, market continuing to fall. Another one here, market continuing to fall. And guys, it's not like this is some type of another one here, market falls again. This is not some type of holy grail candlestick pattern. If you go out and just trade every one of these, it'll be very hard to consistently make profit. But imagine adding some other indications like structure, like trend, like indicators in with this. And imagine how powerful it can be. And that's actually what I'm gonna show you right now is how powerful this type of pattern can be, this 5% candlestick pattern can be. When you start adding other factors into it and create an actual strategy around it instead of just looking at it as a candlestick pattern. This candlestick pattern is not the holy grail. It has losses. You will see times when the market prints this candle and then goes higher, just like anything else in trading. But if you can combine the right conditions to this, it can provide a very accurate trading strategy or a very accurate way to enter a trading strategy. So let's go ahead and go over a trading strategy you can use with this right now. All right, so now let's talk about a full strategy using this candlestick pattern. As I said before, having a single candlestick pattern will never make you a profitable trader. You're not gonna win tons of trades just trading a single candlestick pattern. What you have to do is use that candlestick or that candlestick pattern as a reason for entry combined with other factors. Those other factors can include indicators, structure, with the underlying trend. Whatever you want the other factors to be is fine, but in today's video and for this particular strategy, we're gonna be using the RSI indicator. And this is a very, very simple strategy. By the way, my RSI is set to a period or length of 10. That's the only thing I've changed, is that it is a 10 period RSI. So with this 10 period RSI, what we're looking for, we already know the candlestick formation we're looking for, right? That 5% candle. We need a candle that's going to close in the top 5% of a green candle or the bottom 5% of a red candle. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna look for this in extended markets. So what we wanna see is an overextended market. The way we're defining that is with an oversold RSI on our RSI 10 period. So if we have the RSI going into oversold, right about here is where we do, this is when I'm gonna start looking for a green 5% candle. So at this point, as we go into oversold, I wanna start looking at my candlesticks and see if I get a green candle that closes in the top 5% of that candle. Do you guys see the one I ended on right here? This would be the entry candle. So that's the only criteria for this strategy. I'm about to show you the results of this back test and we'll go over the strategy a little more. But remember, what we're looking for is extended markets, overextended markets. So if a market goes into oversold, we're using a 10 period RSI. A market goes into oversold, while the market's oversold or either coming out of oversold, we want the market to do that with one of these 5% candles. And I'll go ahead and go over these stops and targets for this. And EAP members, I have a full strategy I'm working on with this for you guys here on YouTube. I'm gonna give you an explanation of how you can develop a strategy using this, and I'm gonna share with you the back testing results I have here on the Pound Canada. Before our stops and targets, I did 10 pips below the swing low. So we have 27 to the swing low, it'd be 37. And I did a 1.4-to-1 risk reward. So if I bring this down to 1.4, you can see that we hit that right here on this candle. So that was a winning trade. And what I'll do is go ahead and put another arrow on this. And now I wanna show you guys the results of this. So if I zoom the chart out, you'll see red and green lines here. And we're gonna go over a short version of this in just a second, a bearish version of it. But if I zoom the chart out, these are my wins and losses. Green is a win, red is a loss. I tested this from 2018. And with that test from 2018 until today's date with this, using the same exact rules that I just taught you, and we're gonna go over a short example in just a second, we'll go over a bearish example, but using those same criteria with the RSI set to a 10 period and waiting for it to go oversold or overbought and then waiting for that 5% candle to pop us out of oversold or overbought conditions, using that same criteria, we produced 57 wins and 30 losses, a total of 80 trades, giving a 65% chance of winning. And this is all with a 1-to-1. This wasn't quite a 1.4-to-1, but that is an incredible win rate for just using overbought and oversold trades with a simple candlestick pattern like this 5% candlestick. And that's one of the reasons that I absolutely love this candlestick pattern, guys. Here is a overbought situation. We have a market coming into overbought. We come into overbought back here, actually. We don't have... Remember, when we get into overbought, we're looking for a red candle that closes in the bottom 5% of that candle. We don't have that anywhere. We don't have that here. The candle this green line's over, you actually cannot see that, right here is when we get it. Notice what price does once we get that candlestick pattern coming out of our overbought situation. We have a major push down. So for a sell trade, we would just be waiting on the market to come into overbought using our RSI 10 period, and then we would be waiting on this bottom 5% red candle. This 5% red candle would be the entry stop 10 pips above the swing high, which would be over here. So it'd be 10 pips above this target, whatever you want to use as targets. 1-to-1, 1.4-to-1, 1.5-to-1, 3-to-1, totally up to you. But that is a look at how you can use the 5% candle to build an actual strategy and to build an actual trading plan. All right, so I really hope you enjoyed that beginner lesson, but if you are ready for some more advanced training, then we just had a few graduates come out of the EAP Training Program, our flagship program here at the Trading Channel. I'll post some of their testimonials on the screen. And that is incredible news for them, And that's also incredible news for you, because that means that we finally have some spots available in the EAP training program. And while you glance through some of the comments on the screen, I want to tell you that if you're struggling to profit right now, then I've been where you are too. I struggled for over a year before I found a way to be consistently profitable. I made every mistake you can think of. I moved stops. I used poor risk management. I traded strategies that didn't work. I followed a signal service that ended up with me almost blowing my entire account. But after that first year, and after nearly blowing an entire account, I found the real path to trading success. And consistently profitable trading became as easy as counting to six. And that is what I teach in the EAP training program. I created a strategy that only uses six simple rules to create an edge over the market. So once you memorize these rules, trading becomes as easy as counting to six. These rules are completely objective and easy to follow. And although just having a strategy is only one part of the equation, it is a very large part of that equation. In the EAP training program, we also have lessons on risk management and discipline to make sure that you have everything you need to get on the right track to becoming a consistently profitable trader. And here's a look at some of the things that are included in the course. As you can see, we have beginner lessons that teach you everything you need to know about technical analysis in terms of what you're going to learn in the course. We have a transition course, which is meant to take you from where you are to becoming consistently profitable. And after that, we have an advanced course that is meant to take your trading to that next level. We also send out 3 to 5 email alerts every week. These are not meant as signals. Let me clarify that. But instead, meant to show you exactly how I am looking at the market. And we also do a review video at the end of every couple of weeks to show you how the strategies are performing. And you can check those out right here. So if more advanced training is something that you are looking for, then we do have a few spots available in the EAP training program. This program also comes with priority email, meaning you can email me at any point that you have questions and I will answer you ASAP. So if a trading mentor is something you are looking for, then look no further. Go ahead and click the link in the description for the EAP training program, and it would be a pleasure to have you aboard and to have you join us in the EAP training program. If not, that's totally fine too. Make sure you're subscribed here on YouTube. Make sure to click that like button for me if you enjoyed this video. Follow us on Instagram at The Trading Channel, and I will see you in the next video. We'll be right back.